Welcome to the Ops Manager introduction demo. Operations and IT teams have a lot on their plate. MongoDB Ops Manager helps you automate time-consuming database administration work with built-in best practices developed from managing tens of thousands of production deployments. Built by MongoDB engineers, Ops Manager is the management platform that makes it easy to deploy, monitor, backup, and scale MongoDB on your own infrastructure. In this demo, we will see how you can set up an instance of Ops Manager on your hardware and see how quickly you can deploy MongoDB resources from a centralized admin dashboard. We're going to deploy Ops Manager 4.4 with the following systems set up in advance. We'll use a Ubuntu 18.04 image on AWS on a T2 large. You can substitute your favorite provider or a bare metal setup here if you prefer. MongoDB will be running on port 27017, the default port. We'll be running a standalone deployment, but it is recommended to use a replica set for production. The Ops Manager installer will be downloaded locally. Before you begin your installation, you should download a copy of the installer for your platform from the MongoDB Download Center. A link for this is presented on screen. Finally, we'll be logged in over SSH. Please note, this is just a demo setup. We support a large number of different configurations. To see a complete guide, please consult documentation at the link on screen. Let's open our SSH session to the server and begin installing Ops Manager. So let's install Ops Manager with sudo dpkg-i mongodb mms 4.4.dev. And now we will start the MongoDB service. This will take a few minutes in startup. You can watch your progress through our service or the MMS logs. To see logs, you can go tail-f opt MongoDB MMS logs MMS0.log. Great. Now we have our Ops Manager instance up and running, but we still need to configure the server. Let's do that now. First, go to the web interface for Ops Manager. By default, we run on port 8080 for HTTP and 8443 for HTTPS. Now we must register our first user. This is the global owner of the system, and they have full access. Let's enter our user details and click register. At this point, Ops Manager will guide you through several configuration pages. Required settings are marked with an asterisk. If a restart is required, they will be marked with a double asterisk. When configuration is complete, Ops Manager will open the deployment page. Let's set up our demo system now, highlighting some settings that may be of interest. Under Web Server and Email, the Web Server settings allows us to set the address for the server, which is used by all agents connected. Other settings of note include HTTPS, where we can configure a certificate for secure communication with the server. This cert can either be signed by a public root authority or one provided by your organization if required. Email settings are required for Ops Manager to allow the system to notify users on alerts, as well as common admin tasks such as resetting forgotten passwords. For this demo, I'm going to use some throwaway settings to show how this is configured. Ops Manager can easily be integrated into your existing authentication infrastructure or provide its own user database if required. Examples of some common configurations here would be an application database. In this case, we would configure your Ops Manager service to use MongoDB CR or Scramshaw authentication for communication between Ops Manager agents and deployments. With LDAP, in this configuration, users log in through Ops Manager. Then Ops Manager searches the LDAP directory for the user and synchronizes the user's name and email addresses in the Ops Manager user records with the values in the LDAP user records. With SAML, you can use an identity provider that runs a SAML service to manage Ops Manager user authentication and authorization. When you try to navigate to Ops Manager without an authenticated session, Ops Manager sends you to the identity provider where you log in. After you authenticate, you return to the Ops Manager application. Usage information allows us to collect information so that we can provide a better experience and support you in the future. All usage information is completely anonymous and confidential. By default, this is disabled. Backup. A benefit of using Ops Manager to manage your deployments is a rich backup solution provided. Once a backup is started, Ops Manager backs up the data as an ongoing and continuous process. This process continues creating snapshots as long as the head database remains synchronized with the database. In this section, we can configure how much Ops Manager compresses file system store snapshots, how frequently Ops Manager takes snapshots, and how long Ops Manager stores snapshots. For now, we will just accept the default values. KMIP. For encryption of your data, MongoDB Enterprise supports secure transfer of keys with Key Management Interoperability Protocol, or KMIP, compliant key management appliances. Any appliance vendor that provides support for KMIP is expected to be compatible. To encrypt backups, you use a master key that is a KMIP key management appliance generates and maintains. This master key encrypts the head databases. As a backup daemon creates snapshots from the head databases, resulting snapshots from the encrypted head databases are themselves encrypted. For this demo, we will leave this unconfigured. Queryable snapshots. Ops Manager provides queryable backups. This functionality allows you to more quickly query specific backup snapshots. You can use the queryable backups to restore a subset of data within the MongoDB deployment, compare previous versions of data against the current data, and identify the best point in time to restore a system by comparing data from multiple snapshots. For this demo, we will accept the default values here. HTTP and HTTPS proxy. Ops Manager can pass all outgoing HTTP and HTTPS requests through a proxy server. The settings below allow us to set this global configuration for all users of the system. Twilio integration allows users to receive their authentication codes via SMS. Administrators can optionally enable integration with Twilio. The MongoDB version management settings determine how Ops Manager knows which MongoDB releases exist and how the MongoDB binaries are supplied to the Ops Manager server. The automation and backup daemons use these binaries when deploying MongoDB. Here we will set the sources for installers. We have three modes: remote, hybrid, and local. In remote mode, agents get MongoDB binaries from a remote source. In hybrid, agents get the MongoDB binaries from Ops Manager, which in turn fetches binaries from the remote source on their behalf. Finally, in local mode, agents get MongoDB binaries from Ops Manager, which has them on its local disk. Note, for both remote and hybrid, the installers can be sourced either from MongoDB servers or a local S3 compatible HTTP file server. The alerts webhook URL allows us to send alerts as a HTTP post request to an endpoint for programmatic processing. The request body contains a JSON document that fully describes the alert that has occurred. At this point, we can click Continue and our Ops Manager global settings have been configured. We will now be brought to the deployment page to begin our first deployment. From the deployment screen, you can use Ops Manager to create new deployments and manage existing ones. To monitor existing deployments, you will need to download Ops Manager agents to the servers in the deployment. We will discuss how to make your first deployment in another video in this series. For now, we will look at the admin operations that can be performed from the interface for admins new to the system. For users of previous versions of Ops Managers, you may notice an updated component layout on the screen. All previous elements are still present, but they have been grouped more logically. There are some improvements of note. Feature requests. This links to the recently deployed MongoDB feedback engine, allowing users to share ideas for improvement that they would like to see in our products or to vote on existing requests that would improve their experiences. Access Manager. The improved Access Manager now brings together access settings for all your projects to more easily update these important settings. And an improved organization settings access. Organization configuration is now easier to access and configure. When installing Ops Manager, we set a number of configuration options, all of which are part of the global configuration of Ops Manager. On the admin panel, we can change these at any time, as well as configure and review other aspects of our installation, If you're in a main of Ops Manager, a new admin button will appear on the top menu bar, allowing access to the main panel. Here we can see the following areas. Under General, Overview gives a high-level view of our installation, including running processes and warnings that have been raised. Ops Manager Config. Many of the options we configured in our initial setup can be changed here, along with the ability to enable monitoring of our application database and also set advanced configuration overrides. Under Users, here we can update user permissions, as well as revoke access to individual users if required. API Keys and Global Whitelist. These two sections are commonly updated together. API Keys allow us to create keys for use by external systems to interact with Ops Manager through its REST API. As well as defining API keys, we must define IP whitelist for these keys to be allowed access to the server. Projects and Organization. Both of these give a centralized view of all projects and organizations on this Ops Manager installation. Logs. This page lists logs by job and class with messages grouped and counted by last hour, 6 hours, and last 2 days. Click an account number to see all messages in the group. Version Manifest. This allows the admin to configure the list of MongoDB community and enterprise releases that can be deployed by this instance of Ops Manager. Note, unless running in local mode, this list is automatically fetched from MongoDB servers and does not need to be maintained. Messages. This page displays messages you have added to the Ops Manager interface. You can add a message to any page in the Ops Manager interface to notify users of information and events, such as impeding maintenance windows. Audits. This page displays all events tracked by Ops Manager. This includes the group events, as well as internal and system events, which are not tracked at the group level. MongoDB Usage. If the MongoDB Usage UI is set to true, this page displays information about the MongoDB usage collected via daily snapshots. Backup. The admin interface's backup tab provides information on backup resources, including jobs, daemons, and block stores. Initially, you will need to configure a head database. This is a copy of a backed up deployment stored on the backup daemon server. The daemon maintains a head database for each shard or replica set it backs up and creates periodic snapshots. The daemon stores the head databases in the head directory. Once that is configured, we will add a block store. This is the database that stores your snapshots. The block store uses a storage format that parses a snapshot into smaller chunks that allow Ops Manager to manage snapshot changes. Ops Manager supports the following snapshot stores: on the file system, in a MongoDB database called block store, or in an S3 bucket called the S3 block store. Once all steps have been configured, you will then be able to schedule backup jobs, which will make incremental backups of your deployments and store them on the block store. Alerts. The admin interface alert tab sets and displays global and system alerts. Global alerts apply a group level alert condition to multiple groups. System alert monitors the health of Ops Manager. Control panel. This area displays alert emails and, if configured, SMS messages which have been sent to the recipients. Admins can also send test messages to users to test the validity of their addresses. I hope you enjoyed the introduction to Ops Manager given in this demo. Thank you for your time.